The Tesla app is a must download if you own a Tesla Model 3. If you own any Tesla, to be honest, the Tesla app is essential. And that's because it offers loads of additional functionality through your smartphone, as well as making accessing your Model 3 far easier. I'll run through everything your Tesla app can do for you to make your Model 3 work better for you, as well as the things I think it's missing or could do with improving upon. So if, like me, you ordered your Tesla Model 3, your next stop was to download the Tesla app. You log in with your account details, and then that's pretty much it. The app doesn't really do much. You count down the days to your Model 3 delivery, and then just before you get to the Tesla service center, you find your Tesla app springs into life with way more options. And that's because the service center will enable your app just before delivery. The reason is you can pip your horn, flash your lights, open your boot, all while your Tesla Model 3 is sat on a container ship crossing the Atlantic, or sat quietly in a Tesla showroom. And yes, you could do all these things through the Tesla app because your Model 3 has a built-in cellular connection, so your app is always connected to your car. So for that reason, as people have clearly done it, Tesla disable your app until you actually get to your service center. So let's go through all these options the Tesla app gives you. First of all, I'm on iOS, although the layout is very similar on Android, so you don't have to worry about that. The app is a little bit slow to open sometimes, and that's because it wakes your car up from sleep, or is connecting to your Tesla account, which means that there might be some delay. And in today's society, we're expecting instant results when we press a button. That can sometimes be a little bit annoying, especially if your Model 3 takes a while to wake up. On the main screen, you have a general overview of Tesla products you own. So, for example, I've just got my Tesla Model 3, but if I had a power wall, I could swipe right, and that would give me an overview of the products for that. You get a live status of your Model 3 as well, so you can see I'm currently parked with an 80% state of charge. If I was charging, it'd tell me how long there is left to charge, and also they show you cool things like if you'd accidentally left a door open or your lights on, it would show you that's the case. So if I open this back door here, you can see it opens straight away and gives an animation on the car screen as well, which is pretty cool. The other thing you can see from this screen is an instant view of what the climate's doing in your car. So for example, the interior is currently 22 degrees, but a word of warning, that can sometimes be a little bit slow to update, so just give it 4 or 5 seconds, and then generally it'll give you an accurate view of what the interior of your car is doing. And it actually highlights as well in summer how hot your car actually gets. This regularly, even on UK summer days, it can sometimes get as high as 40 degrees in the car, and it's not a particularly sunny day. Quick actions along the top enable you to turn the aircon on, pop the trunk, or lock or unlock your car. My only downside of this is that you can't customize this. So for example, I don't really use the trunk that much. I'd rather this quick action be the boot. In the main section of the Tesla app, we have the phone key element at the top. So if you download the Tesla app before you go to pick your Model 3 up, the assistant will normally help you set this up. Otherwise, you'll just have to use the key that you get given, which is a small credit card, to drive the car initially. If they don't help you set up the key in the Tesla app, it's not that hard to do, and there are instructions in your Model 3 manual. Once you've set your phone key up though, that is it. You can just walk up to your car with your phone in your pocket, open the door as if it was unlocked all along. You type your PIN into drive and you're away. You don't have to rest the key card in a specific place. If you want a bit of reassurance your car's actually locked when you walk away, you could put on sound horn when the car locks. I just look back and double check the wind mirrors are folded in though, but the range isn't huge, so you actually generally hear your wind mirrors folding in as soon as you're walking away anyway. Beneath the phone key is probably the option I use the most, which is climate control. And it's really handy in winter when you're coming back to what's going to be a really cold car. You can turn the heating on and even turn on the heated seats to whichever setting you prefer. So if you know you're going to come back to a frosted over car, put the heating on 10 minutes before you get back and your car's going to be completely defrosted, ready to drive when you get in it. Just bear in mind that the heating does hammer the battery a little bit, so make sure you only time the heating to come on just before you're due to drive. And you're going to use that battery capacity anyway once you get in the car, you just don't want it heating say half an hour before you get in there. So in the control section of the Tesla app, this is the section which probably gives you the most functionality to your Model 3. So for example, you can vent your windows, which opens all four windows to let a bit of air in or close them up again, lock or unlock your car, flash your lights, honk your horn, which is always funny if you've got an unsuspecting person walking near your car. And then you've got this option here to start. So if I click that, it will use Face ID. And now I have 2 minutes to just get in my car and drive away without having to enter PIN to drive. Handy if you've robbed a bank. but probably more useful if you've got someone coming in your car and you don't necessarily want them to see the PIN for whatever reason. So you could start your Model 3 through this way, and then once you get in the car, you're not going to have to type your PIN in front of anyone, which is quite good. And what I've done as well is set my iPad so that can also be the key. So if I did lose my phone or the battery went flat, I've got a backup and someone could remotely start my car for me, so at least I could drive it home. And don't forget they can unlock it as well, because that works through the app. You've got the option to pop the frunk or the boot, and for each of those cases it does ask you, do you want to do it? Because don't forget, in the Tesla Model 3 they're not power assisted, so once you pop the boot it's going to stay open. Beneath those key features there, you've got an option to turn on valet mode, which locks all your key compartments like your glove box and your frunk. It blanks off personal information off the center console and also limits the performance of the car, so it's not going to go around at 150 mile an hour and it won't do 0-60 in 3 seconds. So unfortunately we're spoiling the valet's fun. It removes the pin to drive, so you don't have to go around sharing any of that either. And when you come back, you just flick off valet mode, your car's back to normal. Beneath the valet mode, you've got sentry mode, which normally is turned on or off automatically depending on the location of your Model 3. But if for some reason you wanted it on, you've got an option to flick it on or off here. Sometimes I've turned that off in the past when I've noticed my battery drain is getting a little bit low, so I've just taken the sacrifice because it does use about 150 to 200 watts per hour. I've done a whole video on sentry mode, check that out here if you're interested in that. Beneath that is speed limit mode, where you can actually choose how fast the car will go. I'm guessing that's more useful for if you're lending your car to someone and you don't want them breaking the speed limits and getting you any tickets sent to you. Also, if you've got younger children that are learning to drive, you can limit the performance of the car. The charging part of the app lets you have a look at the current state of charge. If you're actively charging, it will tell you how long is left. You can open the charge port ready for charging, unlock or close the charge port as well. And also you can choose how much charge you actually want. And you can see there it's actually showing a percentage. Whereas if you choose the amount of charge you want in your Tesla Model 3, then actually it's a bit of guesswork because you can't always accurately see the percentage. So one of the handy features in the charge section, you get a list of nearby superchargers. And if I was to click on one of those, it would actually start navigation through my Model 3 to that supercharger. One of the downsides is you can't look at further away superchargers, and I like that displayed more in a map feature, so I could scroll to where I'm going and check the availability of those ones. Further down as well, you've got destination chargers, but these tend to be smaller rate chargers, so around 7 kilowatts, and you generally have to be a customer at the venue to be able to use them. A couple of issues I do have with the app is that you can't schedule charging. So if you don't have a smart charger like the Tesla wall socket, you'd have to come into the center console to schedule your charge. It seems a bit lame considering the third-party apps can actually do that for you. Also, because I've got the car's display set to energy, I can't actually see the miles range, and you'd have thought it would have been able to compute the two and maybe display both of those on the app. So rather than seeing a percentage charge, I see actually how many miles range and percentage charge at the same time. Beneath the charging, you've got the exact location of where the car is. And if you could see where I was situated, this is very accurate. I'm literally in the right parking spot. In fact, you can see where the blue dot is. You have an option to focus on the car, where you are, or choose a satellite or standard overlay. And if the car's actually moving, you'll see exactly where the car is and the miles per hour. So if you were monitoring your child and seeing how fast they were driving, you'd be able to spot that. Not to mention, if your car did get stolen, you'd be able to tell the police exactly where it's going. Beneath location, we've got summon, and I'll be honest, it's very hit and miss. I'd love to know what your guys' experience of it is. I'm not gonna demo it now because I'll probably end up in the middle of a car park and nowhere to go. But in theory, once your car's connected, you have an option to push down forward to make your car go forwards. Reverse will obviously make it go backwards. And then there's potential for smart summon as well, where you can draw a pinpoint on a map and then it will draw the route it's going to take. So it's trying to come to the target over here, and it looks like, by the looks of that, it's going to drive straight through a hedge, which is always reassuring how that's going to get to there. But it is severely limited as well in the UK at the moment due to EU regulation, so it has a very small radius, whereas in America it can go a lot further. But it's nice that it draws the kind of route it's planning to take, and it looks like it's figured out it shouldn't drive through a hedge on this occasion, which is nice. I'm not going to give it a go because it's a very busy car park and I have no faith in it, to be honest. So underneath summon, you've got the option to upgrade your Tesla Model 3, and depending on what Tesla Model 3 you have will depend on what options you have. So for example, some of the higher end models have an option to pay £2,000 and you get an acceleration boost. For me, I've just got the option of adding some rear heated seats, which are already built just under here. So if I was to click that, pay with my credit card, then actually within about 5 minutes I'd have reheated seats in my car, which is pretty amazing. I found that when I added the full self-driving, that took about 5 minutes to upgrade, and then I was out playing with the new features straight away. I'm guessing they might add further functionality going forward into the future. Like, there are rumors that all the speakers are built into this car as well, so I might be able to buy premium speaker quality in the near future. Underneath the upgrade section, you have the service section, which is probably the easiest and quickest way to report an issue with your Tesla Model 3 and book a service appointment. It tells you your near service centers, and if you want to schedule a service, you just click on that, tell them what's wrong with your car. We'll go with other, because that's what I did when I had a paint issue. Click something else, click next, and then it will give you an option to write a brief description and upload any photos, and then schedule in a date best for your repair. So just remember, if you're reporting an issue, take some photos on your phone first so you can upload them at the same time. I've used it a couple of times and it seems pretty decent, to be honest. The two times I've had it, it's always been paint issues, and like the last time, I'd requested a certain date. That day the paint guy wasn't in, so they just rearranged the date for me, and it's been a pretty smooth process. Then at the very bottom of the screen, you've just got how many miles you've done, your VIN number, and then the version of software you're running, so you can keep an eye on that. And any software updates, you get a notification through on your phone, and you can start to upgrade the software without having to go out to your Model 3, which is pretty good as well. So at the top left of the screen, you've got the settings, and you've got a few things in here. So you've got an inbox, which is where sometimes Tesla will communicate with you. You can see they don't send many messages there. You've got your loot box, which is if you're making referrals to get free supercharger miles. You'll see how you're doing with that. You can refer contacts and share your link. So don't forget, if you're buying a Model 3, use my referral code, because then we both get 1,000 free supercharger miles. And thank you, because some of you have already used that, which is awesome, and awesome that you're getting a Tesla Model 3 as well. You've got ways to change your account details, and then here is where you choose what notifications get sent through to your phone. So car alarm is really handy, because if your car alarm goes off, you might not know. Whereas if you're in the office and you get a notification through, you might go out and check on your car and check it's okay. Charging is handy as well, because sometimes if I've had it where a charger has stopped working, and if you're relying on your charge, then you'll get a notification that it's been interrupted, or if it's complete, and you can then go down and detach your charging unit so that you can make space for someone else. You also get notifications, any software updates, which is really cool, because then you get notified of any features that are added, and also whether someone has started, stopped, or failed. I'd turn off the failed one, because I think you will get that quite often. You have an option of enabling Face ID, or if you're an Android, it might be fingerprint recognition, and that's for if you're gonna start your car and give it the 2 minutes where you don't have to enter the PIN. And then the one that surprised me the most is actually calendar sync. So this is where it will sync your actual calendar. So as you get in the car, it will display what your day is like. And it's actually a really nice little reminder of what's coming up, and helps you make sure you don't forget anything that's gonna be coming up. And then top right of this screen, you've got the loot box, which again is just your referrals for the superchargers. And it's a bit of a duplicate, really. I don't think you need that at the top right hand corner. There is a complete rewrite of the Tesla app on the cards from what Elon Musk has said. But when that actually occurs, who knows? Hopefully, if you're picking up or buying a Tesla Model 3 soon, you now know what you're doing with the Tesla app. And don't forget to download it before you get to the service center so they can help you with setup. If you like that, give it a thumbs up, and also don't forget to subscribe, because I do regular videos on Tesla Model 3s. That's all for now. Thanks for watching. See you again soon.